It's game time on UpStreet Online, friends. I'm Holly, and I hope you're suited up and ready to play, because you're on the field today. Let's do it!
All right, everyone, it's time for UpStreet's training camp. So listen, this month, we're gonna help you grow stronger. Now, there are a lot of ways we can grow stronger. We can grow stronger in school, in sports, in our activities, even in our bodies. But what do we do to grow stronger on the inside? Well, that's what this training camp is all about. We're gonna practice getting stronger in the things that will help us love God and love people. And every training camp needs a playbook, and we got ours right here. This book, the Bible, it's the book we read from every week here at UpStreet. And the Bible is so important because it tells us all about God, all about Jesus and how to follow him, and how to love people like he did. And our verse this month is gonna help us understand what the Bible can do for us. And of course, we wanna help you learn it, lock it, and live it. So let's learn it now.
Your word is a lamp for my feet. A light on my path. Your word is a lamp for my feet, a light on my path. Psalm 119:105.
Isn't that awesome? The Bible is like a light that helps us as we're traveling through life. And it's like a lamp that shines a light to help us know how to love people better. But it's not enough to learn it. We gotta lock it. We gotta lock this verse in. And listen, this verse is so short that we're gonna have it locked in no time. And since this verse mentions our feet, let's get those feet moving with a little dance, all right? I want you all to pick your favorite dance, okay? It could be the dab, right? It could be a little gritty, huh? Just a little gritty, huh? It could be like from a video game, you know, like the floss. Is that not, that's not it? Okay, sorry. You know what it is. All right, but just pick a dance that you love doing, all right? So stand up, pick your favorite dance, and then we're all gonna say this verse together. Can I get a beat? All right, so let's try it. You do your dance, I'll do mine. Are you ready? In 3, 2, 1, your word is a lamp for my feet, a light on my path. Psalm 119:105, your word is a lamp for my feet, a light on my path. Psalm 119:105. Come on, freestyle, ready? Your word is a lamp for my feet, a light on my path. Psalm 119:105. Woo! Nice job, everyone. We're gonna have that verse on lock this month in no time, and that's a super fun way to learn it. So learn it, check, lock it, check. Now we gotta learn to live it, which is exactly what training camp is gonna help you do. So, let's go!
Guys, it's Lex. Guess what just happened? My friend Maya called me and she's so mad at her brother Vinny because he took her iPad charger without telling her and now her battery's dead. And she needs it for school. He's done this before and she is so mad. But the problem is, Vinny didn't take it. I did. By accident. I was at her house yesterday and my phone was running low, so I borrowed it, right? No big deal. But when I left, I forgot it wasn't mine and I just put it in my backpack. But I didn't tell her that on the phone. I let her think that it was Vinny. And I know God always says to tell the truth, but I really just don't want Maya to be mad at me.
Lex, that's a tough spot, and I've been there. when you know what God wants you to do, but it's going to be hard and you don't really want to do it? But that's sort of like football or soccer. It'd be like training and practicing and doing all the drills every day, staying in shape, working with your team, and then when it's game day, choosing not to play. Can you imagine doing all that practice and then deciding, nah, I'm not going to play? You wouldn't do that because it's not enough to just train to play football. Someday, you got to actually play football. And the same's true with God. Here's what he says. Do not merely listen to the word and so deceive yourselves. Do what it says. God's saying the same thing, that it's not enough to just read your Bible. You got to actually do what it says. You got to live it out. Otherwise, the Bible just becomes a storybook we read at night. And that's not what it is. The Bible is full of advice and wisdom about how to live and who God is and how to love like Jesus. Literally full of secrets for how you can live the best life. But you can't just read it. You have to do it. That's how you actually grow stronger. You got to put it all together. Everything we've learned this month. You got to read God's word. You got to memorize it. You got to talk to God. And then you got to get out there and play. You've trained. Now go live it out. It's like with Lex. She knows God says, do not lie to each other. But now she's got to do it. She's got to call Maya, even though it's hard, and tell her the truth. Because God knows that lying to our friends could hurt them, and we don't want to hurt them. God knows what's best. This is how our faith gets stronger. Let's pray and talk to God right now. God, thank you for giving us the Bible, your word, so that we know how to grow strong and how you want us to live. Help us to do what you say, even when it's hard, because your way is the best way. Thank you for loving us no matter what. Amen.
So you're saying it's not enough to just know what God says. You gotta actually do it, which means I gotta call Maya and tell her the truth. Oh, it's so hard, but God knows what's best, right? So just do it. Okay, here goes. But guys, you should do something too. This week, when you know something is right, just do it. When your brother is being annoying, be kind. When you feel like whining, be patient. When you gotta tell the truth, tell the truth. Oh, hey Maya, I gotta tell you something.
Oh yeah, you know what time it is. It's time to learn the book. 1, 2, 3.
These are the books of the Bible. When we read them, it makes us stronger. And we learn about our Heavenly Father. When we read all the books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible. When we read them, it makes us stronger. And we learn about our Heavenly Father. When we read all the books of the Bible.
Yo, it's the Old Testament.
Here we go, here we go. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, just to name a few. We got Numbers, Deuteronomy, we call that the Pentateuch. Joshua, Judges, then a story about a girl named Ruth. First and Second Samuel, First and Second Kings, First and Second Chronicles, we're talking about history.
There were a couple of guys who were up to some good.
We got Ezra, Nehemiah, they helped build a wall around the neighborhood. We got Esther, Job, and Psalms. These are the books of the Bible. When we read them, it makes us stronger. And we learn about our Heavenly Father. When we read all the books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible. When we read them, it makes us stronger. And we learn about our Heavenly Father. When we read all the books of the Bible.
Of wisdom.
We got Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, the Song of Solomon. He was a wise king.
Then we're moving right along to the majors.
Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel.
Daniel got thrown in the lion's den. But he wasn't alone.
God was with him.
And then we got the minor prophets.
Hosea, Jonah, and Amos, Obadiah.
Jonah got swallowed by a big fish.
And then we got Micah and Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, and the last book, Malachi.
Titus, Philemon, and Hebrews, James, First and Second Peter, then you got John, he was a revelator. He wrote 1, 2, 3, and then you got you. Let's close it down with Revelation. These are the books of the Bible. When we read them, it makes us stronger. And we learn about our Heavenly Father. When we read all the books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible. When we read them, it makes us stronger. And we learn about our Heavenly Father.